said his statement. He said, can you find it down here? Jesus heard they had cast him out, and we had found him. He said, dost thou believe on the Son of God? He said, I know a lot of stuff, but I don't even know who the Son of God is. And here's what he said. He said, who is he, Lord, that I might believe on him? He said, I want to. I know a lot about him. I know his power to heal. I know his power to hear. But I don't know him. Jesus says to him, he says, and Jesus said unto him, thou hast both seen him, and it is he that talketh with thee. And let me say this. If you ever got the cow, you've seen him. And it's him that talks. Tell you, come unto me. All in that day. It's him that says, if any man have a bird, come and cast your cares upon him, for he cares for you. It's him. Can I say, he will reveal himself to you. Not just for salvation from your sin's condition, but salvation from your problems in life, your sin situation, your self situation, all your situations. Say, but he won't do what I want him to do. And who are you? You're just another person who he knows what's best for you. I read a post on Facebook the other day from a young man who went out with him, served God. You'll not find one thing wrong with anything he did this day. He was at church, went out after church, tried to help the young folks at the church, was asked if he could play some basketball with them, and tore up his tendons. And was down. Now he's on crutches. A couple of days later, he's just over at a fellowship at church, with at the pastor's house, enjoying the Lord, enjoying a fellowship with the preacher, not doing anything wrong, tripped on his crutches and busted his face up. He says, why is this happening to me? My God, why is thou forsaken me? That's how David asked that question. Where are you at, God? That's a paraphrase how Job asked that question. But he realized God's not doing this to me. God's doing this for me. And he wrote a post on Facebook, an encouraging post. Now let me say, it's not as bad as some people. Sometimes we have to come to the place of realizing that some of our own situations we got ourselves into. But we still have the same question, God, why did it happen this bad to me and it didn't happen bad to anybody else like me? I've seen a lot of people get in situations. And it happened worse to them than anybody else that I knew. Doing the same thing? Not trying to go out and be a rebel. Not trying to go out and do anything really wrong. Situation happened. Guess what? You know what they did? They look at it and say, God, where are you at? And God understands that. You will realize that Thomas says, I will not. I will not. I will not. Yet God did not give up on Thomas. You will realize that Jeremiah said, I'll no more speak in his name. God did not give up on Jeremiah. find that Jonah said, I'm not going to Nineveh. God did not give up on Jonah. And even when Jonah got to Nineveh and still didn't want to do what God wanted him to do, God did not give up on him and showed mercy to him by giving him a gourd. And then we whine about the gourd being gone. God still did not give up on Jonah. He still spoke to him. Why? Because God knows what you're going through. But I will say this. If we say, I'm not going to, we regard that. Keep it there. Don't expect God to hear your prayer. And if all we're asking for is so that we can have what we want, asking of this, don't expect God to hear your prayer. Everything God does is for one thing. It's for two things. It's two things. There's for our gain, but for His glory. If our gain does not give Him glory, then He's not going to give us our gain. Or He might. He gave them their request and sent leanness to their soul. He might give you your gain, but He wants His glory. Somebody said, well, that's selfish of God. God knows what's best for you. What's best for you is we'll give Him glory. What's best for me will give Him glory. You say, what if a tragedy happens tonight? I don't say I can handle it. Dear Brother Peter said, you can handle it. I will always pay for you. You wouldn't even live for you. Tonight I will be around for the doctor. Oh, we ought every idle word out of our mouth. And have thine own way, Lord, it's track. I sing that differently than I used to sing that. When I was a young man and got to hearing that, I'm like, woo! Whatever it takes to be more like you, Lord, that's what I'd be willing to do. Lord, I want to be. Think of Brother Brooke. His precious wife had cancer. I said of his son, Makai, who has a son, and he was acting up the last time they went over to him. And had all these health, all these things, and they ended up coming back. And all he wanted to do was go to Ghana and serve God. And that's all he's done, is try to serve God. Why? Whatever it takes to be more like you. I don't know if I like it. But I want it to be, and Lord, I want to be able to say, whatever it takes to be more like you. Lord. Ask Brother Barry. Did he want his son to go before his son to do this so he could be closer to God? So he'd have a better prayer life? Dear God, help us. I don't take this lightly. But I saw the know-it-all do nothing. But the know-nothing do all he needed to know. He knew that Jesus had the power to heal. He knew that Jesus had the power to heal. And he knew that Jesus